Hi, I'm Mr. Beat. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we will look at how price is crucial in allocating resources in a free market. One of the 10 principles of economics is that markets are usually a good way to organize economic activity. A free market always reaches an equilibrium when scarce resources are allocated among competing users. While we know the final market outcome, it is still early to say whether the market outcomes are good or bad. In market economies, prices adjust to balance the supply and demand, which allows the market to reach equilibrium. Prices serve as signals that guide the allocation of resources in the economy. In other words, the organization of economic activities regarding who produces and consumes each good and how much of each good gets produced is determined by prices. For example, let's consider the allocation of beachfront houses. Since there can only be a limited number of houses near the beach, not everyone can enjoy the luxury of living in a beachfront house. So, who gets to enjoy the resource? Those consumers who are willing and able to pay the price of beachfront houses get to live in these houses, while the rest do not get it. The price of houses adjusts until the quantity demanded of beachfront houses matches the quantity supplied. In a free market, prices also determine who gets to produce the good and how much of each good gets produced. Let's look at an example of farming. It is essential that our society has farmers. If not, we would not be able to have easy access to food and crops. However, how do we determine who gets to be a farmer? In a free market, the government has no say in who becomes a farmer or how many crops should be produced. Instead, the decision to allocate workers to farms is determined based on the decentralized decision of millions of workers who are looking for work. The prices of crops and the salary to the farm workers adjust in a free market to ensure that there are people who are willing to work as farmers. I hope our lesson today on the ability of prices to freely adjust in response to the demand and supply has helped you better understand free markets. If you want to explore these topics in more depth, come visit Chegg, where you can see additional topic videos and solved example problems, or you can ask one of our Chegg subject matter experts.